Hello crafters, Heather here, and I wanted to take just a minute to explain what you are about to see. A while back, earlier this year, a customer had purchased a watercolor piece, and she took it upon herself to send you guys a little bit of a message. And this message is an entire story about what it is that she has experienced in gaining this piece for her own collection and then having it framed at Michael's in Memphis, Tennessee, and then from there hanging it on the wall. And I really wanted you to see what her experience was and possibly see just how amazing it is to see what a customer experiences when they take your art and go get it framed. It's really, really cool. Anyway, I want to thank you, Sheila, for allowing me to share this with the world, and thank you for what you've done here with this video. And I especially want to thank Michaels and their framing department, especially Paula at the Memphis, Tennessee Michaels store. She did a great job, and she really made my customer feel very comfortable about leaving her piece. So take a look and see what Sheila has to say.
Hello, Kraaft It Live audience. I'm Sheila Hensley, and most of y'all don't know me, but we have something in common. We actually have two things in common, and I think if you'll follow along with me at the end, you will see all of the connection. So let's start with a timeline. Heather Crafter created a print called Apple Blossom. We all have, many of us have a copy of it. I have a copy of it. And then she announced that she was going to do a more detailed version, which got my attention because the detailed version was going to be larger. And I heard her talk about it. And on a hangout, I saw some of the brush strokes she used. And the more she talked about it, and the more I saw it, the more I fell in love with it and decided that I must have it. So I approached Heather, not quite so gingerly, and said, I must have it. So I'm sending you money, and it's going to hang in my new home in my foyer. It's an original piece of art that I will cherish forever. Please let me have it. Please, please, please. I actually didn't say please. I demanded. And she agreed. And then I asked her to ship it to me because I would be moving, and she did. And I guarded it with my life, and I would hide it from myself and lose my mind and then find it again. I mentioned one day I must find a professional framer. I don't even know how to do that. Disclosure, I'm not crafty, and Heather will tell you that in a minute, that I'm not. So I really didn't know what I was doing, but the very wise Heather Crafter calmly said, Michaels does a really good job for me. And I was horrified. How could I take my treasures to Michaels and have them framed as posters? Because that's the only experience I had with Michaels. I had never spent money. I had never, for the premium service and premium matting and that kind of stuff. So I didn't know. But Heather said so. So I gathered my treasures up, and I went over to Michael's, and I rang the bell, and a very lovely lady came out and said, may I help you? And without being overly dramatic, I'm sure I was, I explained to her how important these pieces were to me, that they were original works of art by one of my favorite artists, and they needed to be done just so, where they were going to hang and how big they needed to be, and I was giving her details. And by this time, I had opened the packaging, and the apple blossom was there, the paper and the brush strokes and that kind of thing. And it was close to me. And she said, may I see it? And she reached for it. She assured me we could do exactly what I wanted. And she reached for it, and it was the first time I realized that she had on white gloves. She had on white gloves, therefore she could touch apple blossom. She was respecting the art. So the lovely lady with the white gloves was looking at the artwork, and I was worried. I was not confident. I didn't know what she was going to do with it. I didn't have experience with advanced framing. Didn't know that Michaels offered it. Sorry, Michaels. It's my bad. I didn't know. And she said, okay, let's get started. And I said, well, I have a disclosure for you. Number one, I can't see very well up close. I can't see details. I have an eye problem. And the main thing is that you need to know is I don't do colors. And when I tell people I don't do colors, they are confused. That means I don't put colors together, one complementing the other one. I can't tell. I don't have that knack. And so I explained to her that I would need to rely on the kindness of strangers to help me with that. And I could give her possibly an opinion, but it was really, really going to be up to her. She started work. She put mats here and this and that. And then she would say, how does that look to you? And my answer was consistently, does it make the watercolor, the artwork, look good? It must look its best. It's going to hang in the foyer of my home. It's the first thing people will see. Plus, I love it, and I want it to jump out at people. Does it do that? And she would look down and she'd say, let's try this. She tried many different combinations. She worked very, very hard on it. Fortunately, we were not interrupted while we were there. And the lady in the white gloves diligently put things together, and she would ask me if I liked it, and I would shrug and always say, does it make the artwork look wonderful? That's what it has to do. That's what I need. She finally realized she's sort of on her own, and she took control, and she put it together, and showed me what it was going to look like and asked if that was okay. And I said, sure, because I didn't know. And I must have looked very, very forlorn, because as I was sitting there, I felt a hand on my shoulder, a very gentle hand, and a man's voice say, you're in the best hands. And that was comforting. I didn't really believe it yet, but it was very comforting. And it was the store manager. And I walked out with the attitude and question in my mind, have I done the best for Apple Blossom? Have I made the right decisions? Am I at the right place? I hope so. I really, really hope so. So 2 days later, I lost my sight. I lost complete sight in my right eye, and I only had 25% in my left eye. It was a very rare thing. I was taken directly into surgery. It was fixed. And 2 days after that, I had not only had my sight back, but it was better than it was before. Lady in the white gloves didn't know any of this. I was recuperating, surprised that it happened, and very filled with gratitude that I had my sight back. And then I get a call from Michaels that said that my prints would be ready on Thursday. On the day that it was due, the lovely lady with the white gloves called and said, I've had a delay. She said it much better than this, much more professional than this. I've had a delay. I could have handed this off to someone else, but it is so important to you. I wanted to do it myself since we had worked together on it. May I have more time? I, of course, told her in one sentence, I lost my sight, I regained my sight. Oh, how horrible, Sheila, for you. Oh, that's just wonderful. So she went through a range of emotions in one sentence, and I explained to her she could have, I had a new attitude of gratitude, and that she could have as much time as she wanted. And I so appreciated her taking the interest in doing it herself. And when she was ready, please call me and I would come and pick up my treasures. She did. She called me and I was so excited. I was going to video the reveal, which was me seeing it for the first time. Actually seeing it for the first time, because prior to that, I really hadn't seen it. I couldn't see details. But now, with the improved vision, I was actually going to be seeing Apple Blossom, something that I really, really loved, for the first time in detail, after Paula, manager of the Michaels store at Wolf Chase on Germantown Parkway in Memphis, had done her magic. Had performed her magic, had practiced her craft and what she did. So Paula handed me Apple Blossom, and it was beautiful. I'm about to show it to you as best I can in here. Apple Blossom, you can't see the entire thing. I'm sorry, but I want you to see the detail as much as you can. I will give you still pictures. Is that not gorgeous? Is that not the most beautiful thing you've ever looked at in your life? She went in my opinion, simple and beautiful. She did not take anything away from the art. And if you could see the color of the matting, I don't even know the terms for these things, the green matting around it, she matched it beautifully, but she framed the watercolor in white linen, which you can't see it here, but when it's hanging on the wall, it brings the watercolor out to you. It brings the artwork out to it, just not in a 3D effect, just the slightest little, it comes out at you like, look at me. And that's the detail, that's the finished product of Apple Blossom, Heather's larger version of it and more detailed version of it. And I did get to pick out the frame because I could see the frame, I could see the details. In the right light, in that frame, where the light is coming from, it will pick up the green on the frame and give it a halo effect, whichever side it's coming from. Now, you're going to say, I'm very excited about it and I love it so much that it's my imagination. No, two people have seen it and said, oh, look, it looks like a halo. So the detail of Apple Blossom comes through. First time I could see it, and it is more than I ever expected. The detail that Paula, the lady in the white gloves, the manager of the frame shop at Michael's, the detail and heart she put in it, she was invested in it. She knew the story. She couldn't wait for me to get there and see it for the first time. And when I liked it, she was so very proud. And she said to me, this is my craft. This is what I do. And that's when I knew I wanted to share it with Kraaft It Live, because you would understand what she was talking about. She was very proud of it. I'm very proud of it. And it couldn't have turned out better. I did not realize that Michaels did that. I do now, and now I have my own professional framer because I have more to do. So I am very, very pleased, and I want to thank some people. I want to thank Paula for putting the time in and using her craft to make me happy and get what I wanted. I want to thank the store manager. I wish I had his name, for the kind hand on my shoulder. I needed it at that time. I was very insecure about what I was doing. And I also wanted to document this, because this piece of art will be inherited by my niece, Janica. It will then be inherited by her daughter, Julianne, who is 7 now. And this documentation, this video, she will have at 30 when she gets it. And she will understand that from Heather's thought an expression, the artist, all the way through to hanging on my wall, the journey that the artwork took. And that's important, I think, it's important for her to know, because she won't know. She won't know the story. And it will make the artwork more important. It just will. It's documentation of an original piece of art that from beginning to it hanging on the wall and bringing joy to others. And most of all, I want to thank Heather. You have brought joy into my life. You can see when people walk in my door, Apple Blossom is the first thing they see, and it comes to them and invites them to enjoy it. It's the most beautiful, one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. So thank you for sharing it. What you do and how you do it brings joy to a lot of people. And this one certainly brings joy to me. So thank you a lot for that.